So in this TelePrime tutorial, we will learn how and when to use alternate units. Hello everyone, my name is Rajiv Kohli and welcome back to our channel, The Teacher. A few days back, I had published a video about how to create single and compound units, and I have given the link of this video in the video description and in the cards. You can go and check it this out, and that is a 8-minute long video. And I must recommend this video to you because it will help you to understand the alternate units much better. So let's get started, and we will see the method of creating alternate unit in both of the versions in TelePrime and TeleERP 9. And you can see that I have a demo company for alternate unit here, and we will move to the master's creation, and here I will move to stock item instead of units. The alternate units are created within the stock items. So you must remember that, because single and compound units are created through the unit creation screen, but the alternate units are created while creating the stock item. So that is the first difference between both of the units. So if I press enter on stock item creation, so here you can see that we have below units section. And here let's say I create a new item, glass, and here below we have the units, and you can see that how many units I have already created in this demo company, and these are the single, compound and the alternate units. So this is the primary unit of the item. So let's say I choose pieces for this, and it didn't ask me the alternate unit. So in TelePrime or TeleERP 9, you have to enable the alternate unit feature, and you can do that from the stock item creation screen right from here. If you press F12 here for configuration, then below here you can find two options: provide units of measure for stock items. If I set it to no, then you can see that it is now not asking for the primary unit as well. So if you create an item without any UMO, unit of measure, so let's see what happened. So now I enter a voucher, purchase voucher F9, let's say cash purchase. Okay, now we are using the purchase account for purchase ledger, and here I will add the item, the glass item. Then it will not ask you for the quantity. So that is why the units are important. And if I press backspace here to move back to the item name, and here if I press Ctrl plus Enter key, then it will directly move to the item alteration screen. And here you can see now we don't have the option for units, so I need to press F12 for configuration, and here I will enable the UMO. So now below you can see, if you will enable the UMO, then you can only enable the alternate units. Without UMO, the alternate units will not work. So I will also set it to yes, and will press the Ctrl A key to save the changes. And here you can see that we have now the primary unit back, and here for primary unit I will choose pieces, and below you can see we now have the alternate units. So here you can choose the second unit for your item as an alternate unit. So let's say I choose box as alternate unit for this item, then it will ask me that how many boxes are equal to how many pieces. For instance, I can choose one box equal to 30 pieces. So that item, the glass item, have two units now, pieces and box, where one box is equal to 30 pieces. So you must remember that you can specify the alternate unit details during the item creation. And let's save the changes, and now we have the quantity. And here if I type, let's say 10, and press the enter key, then it will take 10 as pieces, because our primary unit is pieces. I have again pressed the control and enter key on the item name to see this alteration screen, and here you can see that our primary unit is pieces and alternate unit is box, where 30 pieces is equal to one box. So let's say if I change the amount of quantity here to 50 pieces, then below you can see our alternate unit value and that it converted to 2 boxes. However, they are not complete 2 boxes because for 2 boxes we need 60 pieces, but it will round up the value for the alternate unit as 2 boxes. So let's say if I set it to 80 pieces, then it will change to 3 boxes. So now I will add the rate of per piece. So let's say it is equal to 15 rupees per piece and save the changes. Now if we move back to stock summary from the gateway of tally, then here we have the glass and the closing balance is 80 pieces. And if you want to see the alternate unit along with the primary unit, then you can press the F12 key here and you can ask to display the alternate unit values as well. So here we have 80 pieces equal to 3 box. So you can also enter the secondary unit here while entering the voucher. Let's see. So let's say we enter the glass again and here I choose this time 5 and I type the unit of measure name here. So as I type 5 boxes, then it automatically converted it to 150 pieces. And here you again need to tell the rate of per piece. So let's say if I tell the rate of a box here, so let's say 450, and that is the rate of a box. So if I type the unit of measure name under the per field, then and press the enter key, then you can see that the amount has automatically been converted according to the box rate. So if I say per item, per piece, then it automatically adjusted the rate. So you can see we can type the rate in both ways. So in Tally ERP 9, if you want to create the alternate units, then go to the inventory information, stock item, create. And let's say we again use the glass item. And here we have the units. And I choose pieces as primary unit. And here if you press the F12 for configure, then here you can find that option, alternate units. So here in Tally ERP 9, you will not find the option to enable the primary UMO. You only have the option to enable or disable the alternate units. So here I set it to yes and save the changes. And now we have the alternate unit. So we cannot specify an alternate unit while we only have a single unit. So we now only have this pieces single unit. We need at least 2 simple units to create an alternate unit. So now if I press Alt C, then I will directly move to the unit creation screen and here I will again create another simple unit and I will name it box. So you can also set the decimal value if you want to. And here I will specify one box is equal to 30 pieces. So during the voucher entry, let's say I enter a voucher here in purchase voucher in Tally ERP 9. So we don't have a purchase ledger, so I will press Alt C to create a new ledger account and I will place it under purchase accounts. And now I will type the item name glass and here we have the units. And let's say if I type 180, then it is automatically change it to pieces because the pieces is our primary unit and the 180 pieces are equal to 6 boxes. You can also type like one box is equal to 30 pieces, but you can also say that we only have 15 pieces. So you can also change the value of an alternate unit during the voucher entry. So now let's see the stock summary here. And here we have 15 pieces as closing balance. And if I press F12 here in Tally ERP 9, then I can also ask to show the alternate units. So here we have one box which is equal to 15 pieces instead of 30 pieces, because we can also alter the value of an alternate unit during the voucher entry. So now let's move back to TelePrime, and here I will show you the stock summary here. And here you can see we have a few items, the stationary items, and if I press the F12 key here to enable alternate units, and I also want to see the compound unit detail, because I have used all the three units, simple, compound and alternate, in this demo company. So I am enabling both of these options, alternate and compound units. So you can press Ctrl A to save the changes. And here you can see the detail of all these items further. Like now we have alternate unit, and the items which contain compound units now showing their values according to the compound unit. So as you are seeing this stock summary, now you want to clarify about this second item, that which units has been used for this particular item. Then you can press the Ctrl plus Enter key here to directly move to the alteration screen. And here you can see that only one unit has been used, that is pack of 20 pieces. So the pack of 20 pieces is a compound unit. And let me show you the units which are already exist in this demo company. And for that I will move to the alteration screen units, and here you can see that we have those many of units. And if I press here on box, then you can see all the values of this particular unit, and either it is a simple or compound unit. So you can then start pressing the page down key to move to the next unit. So here you can see that we have another unit here, but that is a compound unit, where box of 10 set means one box is equal to 10 set. And you can use page up to move back to the previous unit. And here you can see that one carton is equal to 20 box. So we have many different kind of units, where many simple units are combined with each other. So I will show you the values that we can add during the voucher entry, and how these kind of compound and alternate unit can help you to specify more than one unit for your item. So let's see. So here we have another item under stock summary, and if I press Ctrl Enter, then you can see that we are again using only one unit for this item, and that is pack of 6 pieces, and pack of 6 pieces is a compound unit. And now I can also press page down here to move to the next item. And here you can see that we have another item here, where the primary unit is a compound unit, not a simple unit like we have used in our glass item. You can see that the primary unit is a single unit pieces, and then we created an alternate unit. But here you can see that the primary unit is already a compound unit. So now here you have 4 types of unit for this particular item, and you will see the benefits of this while entering the voucher. So here we can look at the units value. Here we have one box equal to 10 set, and the alternate unit is also a compound unit, pack of 50 pieces, where 200 pieces are equal to 1 set. So you can see that how these simple compound and alternate units has been used. Let me show you another item where we have used the units as ton, quintal and kilograms. And let's press page down for the next item. And let me show you here. You can see here that the sugar, the primary unit of the sugar item is ton of 10 quintals, which is a compound unit. Then we have the alternate unit as kgs, where 100 kgs is equal to 1 quintal. So you can specify different type of alternate units for each item. Like one item could be of 50 pieces equal to 1 pack, where another item could be of 25 pieces equal to 1 pack. So that is how the alternate unit works in TelePrime or TeleERP9. Let me show you another example here by entering a voucher here, the cash voucher for purchase ledger, and here I will choose the item XT ball pen. And now we will see that how many different types of unit we can use here under the quantity. So let's say if I type 1 here and press the enter key, so the default value that it took is 1 equal to box. So the default value is box. So if we move back by pressing the backspace, and here if I press control enter, then you can see that our primary unit is box of 10 sets. So if you type only the numerical value like 10, then it will automatically take box as the primary unit. And below that you can see that 10 boxes are equal to 400 packs. So how that is, if I press control enter here, so we need to understand the value of 1 pack. So we have 1 pack of 50 pieces. As 1 set is equal to 200 pieces and 1 box is equal to 10 sets, so we now have 10 boxes, that means we have 100 sets, that means we have 2000 pieces. And you can also type like this 13 set and press the enter key, and you can also type like 20 set, and it automatically converted it to 2 boxes, where 2 boxes are equal to 80 packs. Or you can type like this 15-15. So now you can see that it converted that to 15, 1 box, 5 sets. And below you can see that we have 2060 packs. So that is how the alternate unit works, and we will give you more examples in our upcoming tutorials. So I hope this information will be helpful to you. Let me know by liking, sharing and commenting on this video. And you can also subscribe to our channel for more